हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गोइंग टू टीच टुडे चैप्टर 4 ऑफ क्लास 11th एनिमल किंगडम। चैप्टर 4th एनिमल किंगडम, दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द 5 किंगडम सिस्टम। दिस इज अ 5th किंगडम ऑफ RH Whittaker, यानी 5 किंगडम सिस्टम। स्टूडेंट्स, एज लाइक मोनेरा, फंजाई, Protista, Planty, this other than this all 4 kingdom, animal is a more advanced kingdom of the 5 kingdom system. What is the characteristic of animals? Till date, more than a million species, are discovered, named and classified in various phyla and classes. Animal is one of the important organism on earth which having lifestyle other than the plant. The animals are animals are eukaryotic, multicell, having organ system level of organization, and it is having holozoic mode of nutrition, means it is not able to form their own food, it depend on other. General characteristic. Eukaryotic, multicell, that is tissue organ and organ system level of organization, present in this. It is a source. Animals shows holozoic mode of nutrition, means they are not able to synthesize their food, they are depend on other. They make already they use make the food, it means they are holozoic, depend on the other. Holozoic mode of nutrition the animal have. Excuse me, just wait a second. Advanced animal, higher animal have well-defined nervous system. This type of system is not present inside the plant. So, due to presence of nervous system, animal shows more control and coordination as compared to plant. The animal shows division of labor. It is more prominent than plant. Next one is, other than many other characteristics, like they are perform locomotion, they may be sedentary fix, and they may be parasitic, and many other mode of characters can be considered in this, but I am going to discuss part wise. Next topic is diversity in their habitat. Where animal found, where they are not found in the different locality. Now, second character is diversity in their habitat. Habitat, a place where they live. Which type of diversity they shows? Animals present in aquatic conditions, many animals including fishes, small cyclopes, phytoplanktons, zooplanktons, they are also live in various type of aquatic environment. Like in aquatic condition, if the animal present in aquatic condition, it may be as a in the form of plankton. The planktons are those like zooplanktons that swim in water, on the surface of water. This is called planktons. Second is benthon, means those animal which present on the bottom of the any aquatic bodies, either in pond or in sea. Next one is a pelagic. Pelagic, they are freely swim inside the water. They are freely swimming inside the water on the or on the surface of water. This is a different conditions. Plankton what is used for animal, benthon and pelagic conditions also used for the animal. Second is a beside this in aquatic habitat, it may be of two type. First is a marine water if they are present in marine condition and if they are present in the fresh water condition. Marine conditions means they are present in salty water, especially in sea water cases, and in fresh water conditions they are present in the fresh water, generally they are present in the pond or in lake. Second conditions, the animal also present on the terrestrial region. Many animals that move on the terrestrial region, terrestrial that present on the surface of land, and you can say the land animals that are present on the surface of land, they are of many categories. They are classified in many categories. Insects are also considered in this category. Human are also considered in this category. This is called as a terrestrial conditions. Some animals are also classified in two categories, both in terrestrial and terrestrial as well as in aquatic conditions. Such animal is considered under the amphibian category. Those animal which are adapted for dual mode of life, such as terrestrial as well as in aquatic conditions, such this type of animal is considered under the amphibian categories. Now, beside this, many animals are present on the aerial condition. Present on the aerial condition. Aerial means those animal which are able to fly. They are not present on the earth. They are present on the terrestrial surface, but for some times they are mostly they spend their life on the air. So this condition is called aerial. Many birds are considered bird, butterfly, and some insect, flying insect, considered under this category. This is called as aerial conditions. The fifth one is a parasitic. Parasitic. Many animals belong in this category, parasitic category. The parasite may be two type. What is parasite? Parasite which are those organism, those animals which depend on the life of other. Many parasites, some members of arthropods, some members of nematodes are parasite in the humans or other animals, either in the body or on the surface of the body. It is called parasitic. If the any parasite present in the body is called endoparasite. If the parasite present on the surface of the body is called ectoparasite. Ectoparasite generally present on the surface and derive their nutrition from the surface, and endoparasite is present in our body, like in Ascaris and animals of arthropods or some other member of nematodes present inside the body. It is endoparasites like Ascaris, Fusariaria, Pisciola. This type of present animals present inside the animal bodies, like in pig, sheep, and human. And ectoparasite generally present on the surface of the body. This is a different diversity in their habitats. Means animals. Organism belong in animal kingdoms having following method of habitat, following type of habitat, like in aquatic, terrestrial, amphibian, aerial and parasitic. Subterranean animals are also found. Subterranean, they form a burrow inside the soil and live there, like in earthworm, and some snake is considered under the subterranean. Basically earthworm considering it. Now, the five kingdom system further elaborate by basis of following criteria. What is the basis of classifying animal on the following phylum or classes? Now, the heading is basis of classification. Basis of for classification of animal, because Animal have diverse group of organisms. About a million species reported, named and classified. A million species, that means more than 10 lakhs species from the animals are classified. They are classified by considering certain parameters.
They are classified by considering some parameters. So what was the parameter? What was the parameter parameter consider to classify the animals? The parameter is first is a label of organization. You must remember this point, students. Label of organization. What type of what label of organization found in the animal? Let us discuss label of organization. Going to discuss level of organization. What parameter consider? First list all the parameter, then I discuss the one by one. Second is a body symmetry. What type of body symmetry present inside the animals? Body symmetry. Third is a the body organization, either diploblastic body organization, they are, you can say they are either diploblastic or triploblastic. Diplo or triploblastic. Diploblastic or triploblastic. What type of, fourth one is a, what type of coelom present in the body? Is a coelom present in the which type of coelom present in the animal body? Body coelom or coelom? A body cavity. Coelom or body cavity. The fifth one is a what type of segmentation present? What type of segmentation is the body is having divided into the metamerically segmentation, or they are divided into head, neck, and other segments? What type of segment present in the body? Our body are asegmented or segmented? What condition is considered in this? Next is a sixth one is the animal body present having notochord or not? Notochord present in the animal body or not? The seventh one is the body support system. And earth one is the what is the body plan. This is a different parameters. What is the level of organization present in the body? Second is a what is a body symmetry. Third is a what is a body organization, either animal is diploblastic or triploblastic. Coelom present in the body or not? If present, what type of coelom? They are pseudocoelom or coelom, which condition? Segmentation, which type of segment? Notochord present. If the notochord present, the animals is considered as vertebrate, chordate is classified, used this term. If not present, this is called non-chordate. And next, the body support system and body plan. Now the first point is a body segmentation. Let us discuss about the body segmentation. You know that the animal are classified into various category. Some animal having first in body segmentation, the not body organization, but in body organization, the animal body is classified into the categories. First is a, the body shows tissue level organization. Second, body shows organ level organization. This is a tissue level organization. And C is considered as a organ system level of organization. This is a three level of organization, especially tissue level organization in animals, especially the member of poriferans. Member of poriferans shows tissue level of organization. Here example is considered as a member of porifera. The organ level of organization is considered example is a cylindrata. Now the organ system level of organization from annelid, arthropod, annelid to chordate. Because their bodies work as a coordinated manner. From annelid to chordate, they shows organ system. Here some member of helminth also shows organ system level of organizations. So this is a body label organization. What type of label of organization present inside the body of the animals? Next one is a if the organ system level of organization, then the one question is also arise, which type of circulatory system is present? If the open system, open circulatory system present, then it means that the blood directly flow inside the sinuses, not inside the blood vessel. This type of circulatory system found is considered as a open circulatory system. Member of arthropod shows open circulatory system, and the member of other animal like echinodermates and mollusk and many chordates is considered under the closed circulatory system. Then this word is also used, open and closed circulatory systems. This is the parameters which are used basically for classification of the organism. Now second is, what is a body symmetry? What is a body symmetry? Which type of symmetry present inside the body? Second plan is what parameter is body symmetry? Students, you have ever seen in class 9th, you have seen already, you have listened this word symmetry. Which type of symmetry present inside the animal bodies? Like if the body doesn't show any type of symmetry, this is called asymmetrical body. And if the body shows symmetry from various plane, is considered under the radial symmetrical body. Radial symmetrical body. And if the animal shows symmetry from a single plane, mid plane, is called bilateral symmetry. Bilateral symmetry is considered a more advanced symmetry than all other. Bilateral symmetrical body. Let us understand this. Suppose the asymmetrical body is basically the lower sponge, which are branched lower sponge. Lower sponge is considered under this. The sponge having body like this type of body. So this body doesn't shows any type of symmetry. This is a spicules that present on the surface of the body. Spicules. This is the ostia, and this is the body. This is the bottom. This is a lower sponge. The radially symmetrical body, some higher sponge, cylindrate, tenophore. Higher sponge, cylindrate, tenophore, tenophora, and adult echinodermates. Adult echinoderms is considered under radial symmetry. Suppose I'm going to take examples of one starfish. This is a member of echinodermates. If the body cut from any plane, they show symmetry. Such type of symmetry is called radial. If the body cut from a mid plane and all body parts shows identical to the other, this type of symmetry is called radial symmetry. While bilateral symmetry, suppose this is the body of human, the body can show the symmetry from a mid portion. This is considered under the bilateral symmetry. The member of platyhelminthes, annelids, arthropods, mollusk, and many other higher body birds like pieces, reptile, amphibia, bird, mammalia is considered under the bilateral symmetry. This is a more advanced feature. Bilateral presence of bilateral symmetry in the body is considered as a more advanced feature. Students, beside the body symmetry, another character is a body organization. Body organization is an important feature, especially the two type of body organization seen in case of animal. First is a diploblastic, third is a body is either diplo or triploblastic. What type of body organization present in the
animals.
If we compare from lower animals, especially from porifera, to the vertebrates, we find there two type of body organization, diplo and triploblastic. Diploblastic body is made up of two layer and triploblastic is made up of three layer. The diploblastic means the member of porifera and cylindrate. Porifera and cylindrate is considered under the diploblastic method of diploblastic, any two layer of body organization, and one middle layer also found, middle layer in the form of mesenchyme. This is not well distinguished. Triploblastic, the body is made up of three layers. First is a, you can say, ectoderm, here mesoderm, and here is a endoderm. Ecto, meso and endoderms are present in the body parts. This is called triploblastic, and body has body shows only two layers, is called ectoderm and endoderm, is called diploblastic, and some mesenchyme also present in between both. This is the diploblastic and triploblastic body organizations. Now the coelom. Inside the animal bodies, coelom are present. Coelom are three types. Now I am talking about coelom. Which type of coelom? If the animal are not having coelom, it is called acoelom. Acoelom. Not having coelom, it's called acoelom. Our animal is called acoelomate. If the animal shows pseudocoelom, it is called pseudocoelomate animals. And animal shows coelom, well-defined coelom present in the body, it is called coelomate animals. What is the characteristic of coelom? What is the need of coelom in the body? Coelom is the most important part. Coelom present in between the mesoderm. Mesoderm in between, they have coelom. Coelom are the part of the body, a body cavity, where different organ are present in our bodies. Suppose our body surface having ectoderm, and our gut means alimentary canals layer, outer layer is considered under the endoderm. The layer present between alimentary canal and ectoderm is considered under the mesoderm. In mesoderm, some body cavities are well defined, well present in the body, and it is different of our organ, different body organs such as liver, kidney and so many other things, that liver and lungs, this type of organs are not lungs, liver and many other organs present in the mesoderm is considered under the coelom. So what is the main function of coelom? Coelom enable the activity of body. Coelom, what is the work? Enable the activity of the body to resist from the shock. Means if anybody press on any persons that is perform stroke on the body of human, then the coelom protect our body organ. It provide space, coelom provide enough space to our internal organ. And fourth is a, it is a best shock absorber. It is a best shock absorber. What? Coelom. And what type of coelom? Those animals which having no any type of coelom present in the body. Suppose bodies are diploblastic, two layer. Diploblastic means two layer. This is a ectoderm and this is a endoderm. And in between some mesenchyme also found. Is considered under the acoelom. Examples, member of porifera and cylindrata. Member of porifera, cylindrata and platyhelminthes is considered under escalmenthes, sorry, platyhelminthes is considered under the acoelomate conditions. In a pseudocoelomate condition, the member of nematoda especially is also known as, it is also known as Aschelminthes, member of nematoda, shows pseudocoelomate. Here the coelom is not present in a regular manner, it is present in the form of patches in between the mesoderm. Suppose this is a outer layer is called, this is a whole ectoderm, this is a ectoderm and this is a endoderm. Endoderm, the coelom present in the in mesoderm in the form of patches. This is called pseudocoelom. This is called pseudocoelom present in case of nematoda. Pseudocoelom present in the case of nematoda, but in coelomate animals, especially from annelida to the vertebrate, especially the mammal, the outer layer, this is a ectoderm and this is a endoderm and this is the outer mesoderm, this is a outer mesoderm and this is a inner mesoderm, and the layer present in between it in the uniform manner, in the uniform manner, this condition is considered under the coelomate. This is a type of coelom found in the coelomate animal. This is a ectoderm, this is a mesoderm, outer and inner mesoderm. Here derm word is, derm means layer, derma, especially made up of word, Greek word derma. Derma means layer. And here is a endoderm. This is the different layer, different layer present inside the different group of animal bodies. This is the level of organization. In some animal, hemocoel also found. Hemocoel in member of hemocoel found in the member of arthropod and mollusk. Hemocoel is a body cavity present in the mesoderm, present in the mesoderm, where the flow of body fluid takes place, where the flow of the body fluid takes place. Body fluid means liquidy part, either blood or hemolymph, any part of the any blood like part, they are loose connected tissue that flow inside the hemocoel cavity. This is called hemocoel. Yeah, body in mesodermal cavity is called hemocoel, means the member of arthropoda and mollusca. Arthropoda, majority member of arthropoda and some are mollusca, shows hemocoel in their body. Hemocoel, it is a body cavity where the body fluid flow inside it. So due to these conditions, the hemocoel means arthropod is considered under the open type of circulation systems. No any tube to tube canal found inside the arthropods, that's why this is the basic reason of open circulatory systems. Now students, next one is a segmentation. You know that the segmentation of the one of the important features, some of the animal bodies so regular, no any type of segmentations, like member of Porifera cylindrata, Platyhelminthes, nematoda, but the member of annelida, fifth character is a segmentation. Member of annelida shows uniform segmentation. Shows uniform segmentation. This is called metamerically segmented. What? This is called metamerically segment. Each segment is one identical to the other. This is called metamerically segmented. Metamerically segmented means, here suppose this is a earthworm body, and each segment is identical to the one another. This condition is called metamerically segmentation. This is called metamerically segmentation. Some of the animal bodies, suppose this is a metamerically segmented, some of the animal body is unsegmented. Unsegmented. Can you tell me your body is segmented or not? Our body is also segmented, but not as like metamerically segmented. Our body divided into head, neck, thorax, abdomen, and appendages. Same like arthropod bodies, head, neck, and abdomen. Head, neck, and abdomen, they are also classified. Some arthropod is divided into head, neck combined together to form a cephalothorax, and abdomens also they divide. This is the different method of segmentation that are found inside the different group of animals. So some animal body is unsegmented, and unsegmented like porifera, member of porifera, member of cylindrata, member of some member of platyhelminthes, and nematoda is considered under the unsegmented body parts. Now students, then another parameter can be considered as a notochord. Which type of notochord present inside the? On the basis of notochord, this is a 6 character. If the notochord present in the body, it is considered under the chordate animal. If the notochord is not present in the body, it is called non-chordate animal. You can say the non-chordata, and notochord present is called chordata. Chordata, notochord. What is a notochord? Notochord is a rod-like structure. What? It is a rod-like structure present on dorsal body surface. Dorsal body surface. In some cases, the notochord further differentiated into the column. Notochord further differentiated into the column. They form vertebrae. They form vertebrae. If the notochord rod-like structure present on the dorsal surface, this is called chordate. And if this rod-like structure not present on the dorsal surface, this is called non-chordate. Member of porifera, lower non-chordate, porifera to echinodermata. Porifera to echinodermata is called non-chordate. Non-chordate, while the member of you can say from eurocardate to mammal you can say eurocardate, cephalocardate, and pieces, reptiles, birds, mammals, amphibians, these all are considered under the chordate. In some cases, the notochord start differentiation. They form vertebral column. So that chordate is considered under the vertebrate. Means all vertebrates are chordates. One point to be remembered must here, all vertebrates are chordate, while all chordate are not vertebrate. Means all chordate animals that having notochord is not differentiated into the vertebral column. Their notochord not having differentiated into the vertebral column, so it is not considered as a vertebrate. So this one is a basic difference between vertebrate and non-vertebrate animal. Now students, body support system. Generally, body support system deals, the body have any type of body support system, 7. Body support system. You know that the many animal bodies not having a special supporting part. Means our body have different skeletons, exoskeleton, endoskeletons, and that endoskeleton provide to our body a definite support. Means our bone stand me in front of you. But if bone are removed from the body, what happen? Our body is just unshaped body. Our body become a unshaped body. Means our bone, our cartilage form a definite structure to our body, but in some cases this type of bones is not found. So it is called soft body.
soft body bearing animal, soft body, especially the member of Porifera, Coelenterata, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda, Annelida, they have soft body system. They have soft bodied system. Soft bodied system sometimes is written soft bodied, BODIED, soft bodied system. While the some other animals having either exoskeleton, have either hard exoskeleton, especially the chitinous exoskeleton present on the on the arthropod body, hard calcareous shell present on the mollusk body, echinodermate hard calcareous spines present on the echinoderms. In fishes, cartilage are found. In some mammals, bone are found. They form means cartilage. Chitinous exoskeleton and bone, our skeleton system form hard-bodied system. Means this type of animals, cartilage containing, chitinous exoskeleton containing, bone containing animals having definite shape, size and structure to the body. Especially this is a very interesting characters of the animals. Next one is what is a body plan. Body plan means if we are talking about what type of system, is present developed first in the body. Body plan, on the basis of body plan, this is parameters. Body plan, he first they classified in the protostome and second is called deuterostome. Protostome and deuterostome. You have ever listened incomplete digestive system, protostome, incomplete digestive system and the deuterostome is considered under the complete digestive system. Complete and incomplete digestive system. The protostome are those higher group of animals have not higher group, those animals who developed the mouth first, and mouth is adapted for dual function, eating as well as egestion of the digested food material. This type of animals is considered under the protostome. Member of, some examples are member of Porifera, Coelenterata and Platyhelminthes is considered under the protostome. Some other examples can be taken from Escalmenthes also. This is considered under the proto. Here incomplete digestive system are found. Here the mouth work for dual function, work as a dual functions. But in deuterostomes, the anus develop first. Anus develop first and then develop mouth. And in both case, the mouth is used as a consumption of food and anus help in the discharge of the digested food material. This type of digestive system is found in the complete digestive system, especially from member of Annelida to the member of vertebrate, especially on the mammal, is considered under the deuterostomes or complete digestive system containing animals or deuterostome. This is a body plan. This is following 8 parameter are considered for classifying animal into the various phylum. Students, in this class we study the general term terminology, what parameter to be considered for discussion, for detailed study of the animals. In next class I will discuss about
I will discuss about the classification of animal, especially one by one. What is a phylum Porifera, Coelenterata, Platyhelminthes, Aeschylmynthes, Ctenophora, Anelida, Mollusca, Arthropoda, Echinodermata, then Urocardata, Cephalocardata, Pisces, especially the Chondrichthya species, Osteichthya species, Dipnoe and Placodermy fishes, then Amphibian, then reptiles, then birds, and then after mammalia. This is just so long and require up to 7 to 8 part to discuss about detail of this chapter. I think it is a too long chapter. I think students, it is need to you to do hard work regarding by taking this chapters. This is a very interesting chapter. Thank you.